You want to get up?
Hey guys, it's Haley, Cosmetology 120 Lab, and we are going to do waxing of the lower leg. Sorry, I got to fold up some of these towels here. So waxing of the lower leg. So we're going to take the client to our work area, greet them, take them to our work area, and we are going to assess their current situation with the lower leg. We are going to talk about their preferences, any special needs or wants that they have. We are going to do a skin analysis. We're looking for irritated, inflamed, broken, raised, swollen skin. We're looking for open wounds or sores. We're looking for infestation or infection that could stop us from completing the service safely today. All of that in the area to be worked on. As long as that is good, we'll go to the next step, which is the client consultation form. On the consultation form, it asks about any medications or products that the client has used within the last 72 hours. We're also going to discuss any known allergies that the client may have. We are going to discuss any surgeries the client has had within the last 3 months and if they remain under a doctor's care for those. We're going to discuss if the client is prone to fever blisters or cold sores. That just kind of gives us an idea about their skin and possible irritants. We are going to assess if the client has used any exfoliators or skin lightening agents within the last 72 hours, such as AHAs or BHAs, and any facial injections that the client has used within the last 3 weeks. Again, this doesn't really have anything to do with the lower leg. However, it is part of consultation form, and we will discuss it. If the client is free from all of the above, then we would go ahead and prepare for today's service. So we're going to start by washing our hands, so wetting our hands with warm running water. And lathering with liquid antibacterial soap. Rinsing our hands under warm running water. Drying our hands with a disposable paper towel. Turning off the water with the paper towel and disposing of that in the trash. And then we are sanitizing our hands. Hand sanitizer has to be between 62 and 70% ethyl alcohol. This one is 70%. here we are using Barbicide Wipes. They are EPA registered, approved for use in the spa and salon setting, verified as a vericidal, fungicidal, bactericidal agent. We are wiping down our workspace for cleaning and sanitizing with wipe number one. We're going to wipe down our wax warmer and the top of our cart, our single-use items that we may use. We're also ensuring that our wax warmer is on and working, and our lamp if we may need it. And wipe number two is our disinfectant. And we are covering the exact same things with that. So wax warmer, workspace, cart, tops of the single use items. And disposing of that in the trash. And we are going to remove these gloves. And these will be disposed of. Psst, psst. Hey. And then we are going to gather the items that we're going to need. So first thing I'm going to do is put out this sheet. So this is going to cover my bed. So I have my rounds that I'm going to use, and we're doing lower leg wax today. I have some wooden sticks, I have my tweezers, and I have each of my products here. So I have my post-epilation soothing gel, my cornstarch, honey that we're using as wax today, post-epilation wax remover, and post-epilation cleanser. So I'm gonna go ahead and fill our disposable cups with each of those products. And I have put all of those into a tray to keep on the edge of my bed, so they don't fall off of the edge of the bed. And then we're going to bring our client over. She has on her robe. And we're going to tuck the robe just above the knee, so we'll be able to get to the lower part of the legs today. Now we are going to wash our hands again. So wetting our hands under warm running water and lathering with liquid antibacterial soap. rinsing our hands in warm running water. Drying our hands with a disposable paper towel. Turning off the water with the paper towel and disposing of that in the trash. And then we are going to put on our gloves. And we are going to start by cleansing. Front of both legs from the knee down. And then we are going to apply cornstarch powder. And this just ensures that there's no moisture left behind, no residue, oily residue from lotions, etc. Test our wax on our wrist. Allowing the wax to drip on the wrist. Going to apply our wax just below the knee to the ankle. And typically this would take two sections, so we would go from about mid-calf to the ankle, and then we would go again from just below the knee to mid-calf. However, because I'm using a doll, her legs are really short, so we're able to do the entire strip in one little area here. So we applied the wax in the direction of the hair growth. Laid the strip, holding the skin tight. Quickly removing the strip. And then we are going to apply pressure to stop the pain. And then we are removing the wax from the area. I'm going to tweeze any hairs that were left behind. Then we are going to repeat this. And typically I would go to the other side of the table for this, but being as it's a home video, I'm trying to, if I went to the other side of the table, you wouldn't be able to see. Gonna have her roll over onto her back, I mean onto her belly. We can get the back of her legs. We're cleaning the area. Pre-epilation cleanser. Find cornstarch. Dry up any moisture. Thank you. happen with this, we would go to the other side of the bed. However, you wouldn't be able to see it in the video. Our soothing gel. We're gonna roll her back over. And we're gonna apply soothing gel to the front. And we're going to talk to our client about aftercare and maintenance and allow her to go ahead and get dressed. Then we are going to put our products in our to be disinfected. And we'll dispose of our single-use cups and put our bin to be disinfected. This will go in our to be laundered, as well as the client's robe. And we will clean down our workspace again. So again, Barbicide wipes, EPA registered, approved for use in the spa and salon setting, and verified to be effective as a vericidal, fungicidal, bactericidal agent. Wipe number one is cleaning and sanitizing. We're going to wipe down our wax warmer. We're wiping down all of our product. Containers on our cart. Disposing of that. And wipe number two is disinfecting the area. Product bottles. Wax warmer. Single-use containers on our cart. Wash our hands. And we're wetting our hands under warmer water. Lathering with liquid antibacterial soap. rinsing our hands in warm running water. Drying our hands with a disposable paper towel. Turning off the water with that paper towel and disposing of our paper towel in the trash. Then we are going to sanitize our hands.